this is course 107 and you are here in the meeting to study about the pedagogy of the science subject. So let me know, so before learning about that subject, you should know why you are going to learn about that subject. Why there is necessity of learning of this subject. Yes, Riti, Priyanka, Manisha, Anita. So whatever things comes in your mind, please tell. Please share with us.
We are learning this so that we know how we can easily convey the concept to the child to whom we are teaching, to the students whom we are teaching, in a way where they can understand the concept, the basic concept properly, and further curiosity rises in their mind to know the detail about that particular topic.
Okay. Basically, the science learning of, or we can say the teaching or learning of the science subject is to develop the scientific attitude among the teacher and in the student as well. Okay. So, if we see the answer of this question, see the objective. So, whatever objectives are there enlisted in the course 107. So, as a teacher, you should know about the nature and scope, even the importance of this subject at the different level. And here you are the BA teachers. Okay, so BA student teachers. Okay. So, after completion of your course, you are going to going as a teacher for the secondary and higher secondary level, right? So you should know the different methods, different techniques, even you can see different models of teaching. So by using all these things, you can easily, whatever you want to convey towards the students, you can easily convey the knowledge or the information towards the students. Okay. So before that, we, as a teacher, you should know all these things, right? Okay. So can you tell me about the science? What do you mean by science? So all are the science graduates and the masters. Science means what?
Yes, ma'am. Can I reply?
Yes, please, Madhulika.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Science is the study of all the living things that are present in around us. Very basic definition. Okay. So we do study about the plants, animals, human beings, everything that has life.
So what we are gaining in
includes non-living things. Geology, geography, it also includes non-living things.
Very good. Very good, Anita. Madhulika, thank you, both of you. Study about the nature, whatever things are included in the nature, right? And simply we can say it's the method by using which we can acquire the knowledge. Okay, so knowledge about the nature, whatever things are there in the nature, right? So this is the simplest, you can say the simplest definition about the science. But there is a difference between the information and the science. So what is the difference between information and science? Yes, Manisha, Priyanka. See, the learning of this pedagogy, it is very interesting, let me tell you. So what is basic difference between information and science? See, whenever we are telling the definition of the science, always we are using the word that is acquisition of the knowledge. We are not saying that acquisition of the information. So why we are using that particular word, that is knowledge? Yes.
Knowledge includes deeper information, deeper study of whatever we know.
Okay, just recall whatever we have learned in the previous lecture. So we learn about the science, nature of the science. Science in that, science as a process and science as a product. Okay. So just concentrate only on the science as a product, and always product is in the form of particular things. Okay. And all those things, they are nothing but the knowledge. So whatever information with us, we are finding a big portion of knowledge from that, the huge information. So this is the basic difference between the information and knowledge. And there is a saying that all knowledge is tentative. It is not static. It is dynamic. Why it is that? That is, knowledge is tentative. Yes, Manisha, Priyanka, Shruti, be interactive.
Could you please repeat the question, because I was on a call?
Okay. All knowledge is tentative. Or you can say knowledge is not static, it's a dynamic. Why it is so?
Knowledge is tentative.
Yes.
Knowledge is tentative because knowledge is whatever we observe. At the first sight, like we all our perception, like it comes to our perception. We see about it. And we get to know about it. That is just information in the first stage. Whatever you see, whatever you perceive, that is all. It's tentative, like it is not necessary that we learn in detail about whatever we observe. We only learn in detail about what we observe when we are inquisitive or we want to know more about it.
Just recall whatever we have studied about the process. Sometimes unknowingly we observe different things, and I gave you example of the locomotory organ of the three pairs of limbs of mosquito. Okay, so I gave that example for this. Sometimes we are observing intentionally. Okay, and when you finding the repetitions in the observations, after that we are generalizing the things. Okay. So here the generalization can be, so after watching the other insects, suppose they are also having the three pairs of the limbs, so we can generalize that all insects are having three pairs of limbs. So that depends on the observation. Okay, and on the basis of observations, we are drawing certain conclusions, so we can see the inference. Okay, so here, like this, there are different theories or there are different explanations that are generated by the different researchers, by the different scholars, and whatever theories or the, what you can say, explanations are given by the researchers, all these theories, they are replaced by the new theories. So that's the reason knowledge is not static, it's a dynamic, or you can say it is a tentative. Okay. Let's see the different definitions of the science. Okay. If we see, there is no any definition which is universally accepted, because there are so many definitions. And the definition itself reflects, of course, the definitions, they tell us about the meaning of the science subject, but also they also reflect about the nature of the science subject. Okay. So let me tell you the first definition, that is, see, try to focus on the main points, or you can say the main words. Science is a cumulative and endless series of empirical observations which results in the formation of concepts and theories, with both concepts and theories being subject to modification in the light of further empirical observation. Here the science, it's both body of knowledge and the process of acquiring it. So here repeatedly we are using this word, that is knowledge. See, the knowledge, that is nothing but the product. So if you are seeing the nature of the science subject, science is a process, means everything comes, the observations, even the experimentations, drawing inferences, everything comes under the process. But the final thing, that is nothing but the product, that is nothing but the knowledge. And the knowledge is always in the form of different concepts, different theories, different characteristics, different formulas, etc. Okay, so just analyze this definition. Science is a cumulative and endless series of empirical observations. It's a cumulative, this from ekatmik bolte hai, an endless series. See, because just now I told you about the science, it is the tentative. इट इज नॉट स्टैटिक, वो सीरियली वो चेंज होता रहता है. व्हाई? बिकॉज सो व्हाट एवर ऑब्जर्वेशन आर देयर, देयर इज अ कंसेप्ट फॉर्मेशन, देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन और वी कैन सी द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द डिफरेंट थ्योरीज बेस्ड ऑन द एम्पिरिकल ऑब्जर्वेशन. बट दिस ऑब्जर्वेशन इट इज द एंडलेस बिकॉज द अदर्स theories or other scientists, they are also coming, they are also going for the observations, and maybe there is a modification in the light of the further empirical observations. Okay, means here we can say that the previous theories, or we can say the previous concepts, they are replaced by the new one. And science is a body of knowledge and it is a process of acquiring that particular knowledge. See, this tells us about the nature of the science subject. It is a process. It is a process of what? Process of acquiring knowledge. Knowledge that is nothing but the product. Okay. The simplest definition of the science, that is, I think simultaneously we have to prepare the mind map so it will be easy to you to understand. Just wait for a while.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, student, I'm not able to, actually I'm not able to, I think that file extension is not supported by this MS Teams. I have made that rough structure of the mind mapping. Okay, it's your task, you can make it later also.
Okay, ma'am. It is a rough structure of mind mapping.
Yes, yes, I have made that because I want to do mind mapping on the meaning and nature of the science subjects. Okay.
Okay.
There are some other definitions of the science which are very easy. One definition is given by the Arthur Clarke That is, science is the purest form, is the simple extension of the human curiosity. Can anyone try to give me any example regarding the human curiosity? Science is nothing but it is the simple extension of the human curiosity. Yes. See, we are the human beings, and we are always curious about the whatever things are happening around us, in our surroundings. Okay. So always you are trying to find out the different reason why this happened, the particular thing, why this particular thing is happening. Always you are trying to find out the solutions or what are the causes behind a particular thing. You are finding it out. So can you try to give me any one example? Yes.
Ma'am, Rajkumari here.
Yes, so, Rajkumari.
Yeah, it's the extension of human curiosity. Basically, what I understand from this is when we know about anything, then we try to relate more and more with other things, and we try to find out more in depth about that particular object, or maybe about a particular, for example, if I give example for science, when we eat food, digestion happens, and how it happens, why it happens, how, which way it happens. So finding more and more in detail about that is science.
See, what about the small children? वो क्या करते हैं हमेशा हमेशा कुछ ना कुछ questions उनके दिमाग में आते हैं. So that questions that वो किसके बारे में होते curiosity, वो हर एक चीज के बारे में जानना चाहते हैं. तो उनको ये नहीं पता मम्मा मैं कैसे आया, आपने मुझे कहाँ से लाया. So they want to know the answer about the particular question. So ये क्या है, this is nothing but the extension about the curiosity. Okay, ऐसे बहुत सारे examples है जो हम यहाँ पे use कर सकते हैं. Then science is man's attempt to explain natural phenomena. Science is a way of conducting investigation. These are the simplest definitions. The first definition was the purest form, or you can say the simple extension of researcher. He should have knowledge about the different things. अगर वो explain ये phenomena करना है, उसके लिए बहुत सारी चीजों का knowledge होना चाहिए. तो आपको क्या लगता है कौन से चीजों का knowledge होना चाहिए? Yes, students.
Process of evaporation.
Okay, process of evaporation.
States of matter.
What are the factors affecting evaporation?
Okay, I got so many information from your side. What are the factors of evaporation stages? Okay.
Factors for evaporation.
Just try to think a bit more.
The favorable situations, condition required for evaporation.
Okay, favorable situations required for the evaporation. Okay, so basically, the person, or you can say the scientist, if he's going to explain about the particular phenomena, like the why water evaporates from an open dish. Okay, so he should know about the physical structure of the water, about the nature of the molecular action of the molecular action, or you can say the capacity of the air to hold the water molecule. Okay, and even the behavior of water molecule when heat energy is increased. Okay, so the basic things the scientist, or you can say the researcher, should know. So whenever he is going to explain about the particular phenomenon, yes, your answers were also correct. And the third thing, see what we are learning. So yeah, I'm just explaining. If you are going to tell that the science, what you can say, science means what? Science is what scientists do. So here we can analyze these in three parts. The scientists make descriptions, scientists make explanations, and the next is scientists make predictions. So predictions means what? हम predicts कब करते हैं? it's nothing but the extending our knowledge to new situations. जो भी हमें knowledge है हम क्या करते हैं उसको new situation में डालते हैं और बाद में उसको predict करते हैं. Okay. तो prediction कैसे करेंगे आप मुझे example बताओगे? We'll take the previous example. Suppose the water, it's an open bowl.
Water evaporates faster if the surface area exposed to the heat is more.
Very nice example. Thank you, Anita. Okay, and some more examples related to the same example. Just tell me about the prediction. Suppose wind is blow quite.
If the temperature is low, the evaporation rate will be low.
Yes, means if it depends on the temperature also. If the temperature is higher, the evaporation rate is higher. If there is a wind which is blown faster over that particular water bowl.
So we can say the rate of evaporation is directly proportional to the temperature.
Yes, of course.
And we can also say that if the humidity is more, evaporation is less.
Yes. So these are what we are making predictions. Whatever knowledge we are having on the basis of that, we are applying knowledge in the new situations. And we are extending our knowledge to the new situation, right? So these are the basic three things about the definition, that is science means what scientists do. Okay. So these are the three principles, whatever definitions we all saw. On the basis of that, we can draw just three principles. And the principles are an accumulated and systematized body of knowledge, the scientific method of inquiry. So initially we use the word that is investigation, you can say inquiry, and the scientific attitude. And scientific attitude means what? It's just scientific way of thinking. Okay. So again, we have to categorize these three principles in product and process. So which principle comes where? Just tell me. I'm going to repeat the principles. An accumulated and systematized body of knowledge. Okay. This is the first principle. Now tell me, it comes under process or product? Because here we are saying that knowledge, it comes under process or product.
It will be product.
Yes, it is product. Very good, Manisha. Then what about other two? The scientific method of inquiry and the scientific attitude, or you can say the scientific way of thinking. See, here we are only talking about the process and product, and already we know that knowledge, it is nothing but the product, and always it is form of different things, that is the theories, laws, concepts, characteristics, facts, etc. Okay. So whenever we are talking about the investigation method, or we can say the inquiry method, or we can say the scientific way of thinking, it comes under, yes, automatically it comes under the process or product. It is so easy. Don't get confused. It is process or product?
Process.
Yeah, it is process. Okay. So let's see one by one. The body of scientific knowledge. So here we are getting knowledge, and knowledge, it is in the form of, here of course we can classify knowledge. Here we are talking about the science subject, and this knowledge regarding the science subject, we can categorize, or we can say the class, we can classify this knowledge into the facts, concepts, even you can say the generalizations, different theories, laws, etc. So many things are there. Okay. So facts, can you tell me any one fact? And so basically the facts, they are these are the basis of all the knowledge. So whatever knowledge we are gaining, that based on the facts, or we can say the facts, they are nothing
established.
But
established. Facts, yes. Are the some established Yes, some established truths.
Okay, rotation and revolution.
Yes. Can you please repeat?
Rotation and revolution of Earth.
Yes, very nice example, Rajkumari. Thank you so much. Rotation and revolution of the Earth. जो कैसे होता है रोटेशन एंड रिवॉल्यूशन ऑफ द अर्थ. अरे यू कैन से सिंपली यू कैन से सपोज द अर्थ इट रिवॉल्व्स अराउंड द सन दैट इज द फैक्ट राइट.
यस
नाउ टेल मी सम मोर एग्जांपल अबाउट द फैक्ट.
मैम वाटर साइकिल.
डोंट से ओनली द वाटर साइकिल इट शुड बी अ स्टेटमेंट इट इज अ फैक्ट ना सो इट शुड बी स्टेटमेंट.
यस
So for example,
sunrise and sunset.
Yes.
Sunrise and sunset. The sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west.
Yes, that is the fact. See, whenever you are saying the fact.
In deserts, we can see the mirage.
Okay. Some more examples. Very nice example you are given.
Phases of the moon. Phases of the moon.
Yes, it should be a statement.
There is a new moon after every 15 days and a full moon after every 15 days.
Very nice.
Changes between waxing and waning.
Yes. Very nice example. Thank you, Anita. Okay, so understood about the facts. Then what about the concepts? For formation of the concept, there should be certain characteristics. Okay. And there are some essential characteristics on the basis of that the concept formation done. A concept formation takes place, we can say. Okay. For example, suppose if we see the classification. And we are classifying non-vertebrates and vertebrates. And in suppose the just forget about that. We'll use simple example. For example, the mammals, class mammalia, we can say, are the mammals. The mammals, it is the concept. So now tell me what are the essential characteristics, or we can say the essential attributes which are needed to classify the particular category in the class mammal. Yes.
Habitat.
Yes.
Gives birth to a child directly. Mammals.
Okay.
And
mammals.
Thanks.
But there are, I think there are other, any other example? Not example.
They are warm-blooded.
Yes, they are warm-blooded. Yes. Just tell me essential characteristics. For example, they are having mammary glands.
They take care of their young ones.
Okay. Yes. I can give an example. We can give any example of from other subject also.
From physics, I can give ma'am Newton's laws of motion. There are three laws of motion. So to every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. This has been tested and proved.
Here we are talking about the knowledge, and knowledge, it is always in the form of law also. So that can be example.
Yes, gravitation is a concept in physics.
Yes, good. Gravitation is a concept in physics. Who gave this example? Shruti, very nice answer. Okay, the next is generalization. So generalization means what? Can you tell me simple definition of generalization? Generalization means what?
To make it simple to understand so that everyone who's outside the scientific community, apart from the scientists, they should understand. It should be a simple language so that everyone can understand.
Okay, I want some other answers. Good try, Madhulika.
Conclusion. Ma'am, it should have meaningful. It should have meaningful conclusion.
Yes, very nice, Poonam. It is nothing but the meaningful conclusions regarding the scientific fact. Okay. Can you give me any one example?
We throw anything from top, it comes downwards, attracted towards the earth.
Yes, so we can see. So in generalization, see, if you are saying that Newton's law, so that comes under the law category. That is also a form of knowledge. And if you are saying that the particular in the form of segment, for example, all bodies are attracted by the earth. Okay. So that is nothing but the generalization. Okay. So these are forms by using which we can say that the body, the science, it is the body of scientific knowledge. Okay. The next is scientific laws. Just now you give me one example. Okay. So scientific laws are nothing but the factual statement of what always happen in certain circumstances. So just now you give me example of what? Yes, Rajkumari, can you repeat your example?
Yes, ma'am. I told one law, that is Newton's law. The other one I said anything we throw from top comes towards the earth.
Yes. Okay. So this is example of the scientific laws. Even one more law is law of dominance. Do you recall law of dominance?
Yes, ma'am.
What it is? Yes, Poonam.
Ma'am, the dominant gene even in heterozygous condition express itself.
Okay. Good. Okay. So understand about the science as a body of knowledge. And knowledge, it is in the always, we can classify, you can say, we can classify this knowledge in the form of different facts, concepts, generalization, different theories, different laws, different characteristics, etc. Okay. So this is the one part of the nature of the science, that is in science is the body of scientific knowledge, or you can say science as a product. Okay. So these two words sabko yaad rakhne, that is product, and the second one is the process. Okay. So let's see about the process. Science as a process. Kya hota hai process mein? Simply we can say it's a process by which knowledge is acquired. Science is a process. See, science is a process by which knowledge is acquired. It's a process jiski wajah se hum knowledge acquire karte hai. Knowledge is in the form of generalizations, facts, laws, concepts, etc. Okay. But if we see in the process, there are different, what we can say, there are different steps, and we have to follow the steps one by one. There should be proper sequence of the steps. Okay. So what it includes? So basically, the process of science is the scientific method which we apply to find out the solution of the particular problem or whatever things comes in our mind. Suppose we know the reason of the particular thing, why this particular thing is happening. So we are curious people, and to know the reason of the particular thing, we are trying to find out the solution, or we are trying to find out the reason for the particular thing. Okay. So there are different processes, or we can say there are different steps which includes in the processes. What comes under these? For example, the observations are there, the classifications is there, experimentation is there. So what after experimentation, what is the next step there? Yes.
Interpretation.
Yes, interpretation, we can say drawing inferences. And what, see, we are applying whatever knowledge we are having, we are applying the same knowledge, and can say extension of the same knowledge in the new situation. Means here again we are talking about the predictions, right? Then the communication. See, if we see, actually you don't know about the steps of the research. And in research, there are different variables, and we are seeing the effect of one variable on the other variable. There are some dependent, some independent variables, and we are finding out the effect of one variable on the other variable. So again, whenever we are talking about the experimentation, so there should be control over the different variables. We formulate the hypothesis. Hypothesis means what? Have you heard this word? I think
if we formulate the hypothesis, if we are talking about the effect of temperature on particular variable, we say what is the optimum temperature, and if there will be a less temperature, then how the variable will express itself. So by having a different conditions for the variable, we find out formulate a hypothesis where we say that this particular temperature is supposed to be the optimum temperature for that particular variable.
Okay, so this can be a
research. It is the first step.
Yes,
hypothesis is the first step to start a scientific investigation. First, we formulate a hypothesis. Based on that, we do the apparatus setup. Then we do the readings, observations, analysis, inference, everything.
Okay.
So hypothesis is a statement that we try to prove through our investigation.
Okay, and the interpretation of the data. Okay, so
yes,
these
ma'am.
Are observations, classification, experimentation, drawing inferences, your predictions, communication, control over the variables, formulation of the hypothesis, and finally the interpretation of the about the data. Okay, and there is, of course, there is the synthesis and analysis and the synthesis of the data. So these are the different steps which comes under the process, and final product will be, so whatever we have learned before, that is in the form of the concept, in the form of the formation of the facts, the generalization, in the form of laws. Okay, so these are nothing but the product. Okay, yes. Understood about the process and the product? Yes, yes, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it is very easy. See, the basically this topic is about the meaning and nature of the science subject. Okay. So there are so many definitions, and the definition itself reflects about the nature of the science subject. And always it is in the form of two, that is science as a product and science as a process. That's it. I think you all understood this topic very clearly. Yes or no? Always the examination, they
ask
short question on this topic. Okay. Okay, this is 3:15 now. We're supposed to stop here. Okay. Yes,
okay, ma'am.
Okay, please take care. Bye bye. See you in the next lecture.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, students. Bye bye.